Order! Order! You are an incorrigible delinquent at times. Behave yourself, man!
Now, Peterborough has one of the highest rates of tax credit claimants in the United Kingdom, with 68% of families and 76% of all children in receipt of the benefit. Last night's Lords vote has given them some relief from the immediate prospect of losing the cash. But how are they viewing the future? Our social affairs editor, Jackie Long, has been to Peterborough to speak to some of those who could have been affected by the cuts and has this report.
If there's a constitutional crisis, then this lot don't seem too worried about it. As for the planned tax credit cuts which brought it about, well, their parents, it seems, have talked about little else. Dental nurse Malaika Fife is relieved the brakes have been put on the plan. Any cuts to her tax credits, she says, could simply make going to work not worth her while.
I'm a single mum that wants to work and do the best for my children so they can see, obviously, how I work hard for them to have what they've got and for the house that we live in and stuff like that. I don't want to have to totally stop and go survive on, live on benefits.
And is that what you worry, that this would push you to a decision between not working
of not working, because I obviously need to do what's best for me and my children.
Come on, sweetie pie, let's line up. Come on, Tegan. Wow. That's lovely lining up, isn't it?
Nursery owner Deborah Bell is delighted with the Lord's intervention. She says many parents had said they'd have to take their children out of the nursery if their tax credits were cut.
We're quite full now and we'd like to expand and open another nursery, but we've even decided, right, maybe we should think about this now and wait and see what the decision is. We can't go and get another nursery if parents are going to start taking their children out, because then the numbers will go down for us. So now we're on hold with our plans as well.
Peterborough is home to one of the highest numbers of tax credit recipients in the country. So it's places like this where it's vital the government gets this policy right.
Of course, the critical thing now is what George Osborne does next. There are around 14,000 families receiving tax credits here in Peterborough. Most of them are in work. The numbers far outstripping the slender Tory majority here. George Osborne says he's in listening mode, but can he do enough to convince people that he hears what they're saying?
And some of those people are from within his own party. Not all of them feel the Lords have overstepped the mark.
If the Chancellor can satisfy those people that have doubts, and I'm one of those, I have family that will be affected as well, possibly.
You have family on tax credits?
I have a daughter who's on tax credits, hard-working, single mum, has children and relies on that money. So I understand perfectly, as a Conservative, compassionate Conservative, exactly what this means to hard-working families.
Natalie Watson gave up working full-time because she says she couldn't make it pay. Now she earns almost as much in tax credits as she does at work. She says if the government's transitional support isn't enough, she doesn't know how she'll manage.
I'm literally living off my tax credits, so if they were cut, it would be a big loss to me and I would struggle to live.
You know that the House of Lords stepped in yesterday to intervene in this.
There needs to be someone to step in for us, especially me as a single parent. It is very important that I don't have another wage, so it's literally my wage and my tax credits that I live on.
But how much can the Chancellor offer families when he has his eye on the bigger political picture?
Well, joining us now from Parliament is the Conservative MP for Peterborough, Stewart Jackson, who is strongly in favour of cuts to tax credits. And in our Westminster studio, Baroness Angela Smith, Labour's leader in the House of Lords, who has accused the government of bullying peers who rejected the cuts. Stewart Jackson, I'm just wondering, given that you have 76% of all the kids in your constituency are affected by these cuts, what representations you made to the Chancellor about how damaging it was going to be for them?
Well, we want to simplify this system and make sure that work always does pay. And the fact of the matter is that Labour enmeshed so many millions of people in welfare dependency rather than aiming what we want to do and what the Chancellor has done which
is... No, I didn't ask you what Labour had done. I asked you what you had done to represent the interests
well, if you let me
of 76%
finish, John,
of the children in your constituency.
If you let me finish, it was about trying to unravel the culture of welfare dependency and getting more people back into work, part-time work, and full-time work, and getting people off benefits, and that's difficult. Labour's view is that it's wrong.
No, I'm sorry, Mr. Jackson, but you haven't gone anywhere near answering the question I asked you.
I asked you
what representations did you make for 76% of the children in your constituency who are affected by these cuts?
Well, no one wants to make difficult decisions that affect people, and one of the representations
what
I have made...
What representations did you make to the Chancellor about
these cuts?
Let me finish,
Mr. Snow. One of the representations I've made directly to the Chancellor is that the transitional arrangements that he brings forward on the autumn statement in 3 weeks' time should soften the most harsh effects on a group of people who are in work. It is not our business to be making it disadvantageous for people to be working. People
right.
prefer
let
to
let
be working and
this,
not be on benefits.
Let's go across to Angela Smith from Labour. You are unelected and... What were you doing messing around with what was a financial measure which the Chancellor had every right to expect you to respect?
Well, two things. One is a financial measure. He chose to go through a strange statutory instrument procedure, which nobody really understands what that is or why. Basically, it truncated debate, so we didn't have the kind of debate. And the only way we could bring some common sense to the debate and the argument, say to the Chancellor, look at the impact of this. We don't think this is fair. Most people don't think it's fair. Have a look at it again. That seems perfectly reasonable.
Yeah, but the difficulty is I've tried to get the elected member for Peterborough to talk about the kids that affected, but you're not elected at all. And therefore,
no.
What on earth were you doing messing around with it anyway?
Well, we have a constitutional duty to scrutinise legislation. There's a wider argument about what the House of Lords should look like in the future. But what it is now, it is unelected, so we can't just chuck out government's programme. But we can get the government to reconsider, and we can say, we believe this is wrong. When Patricia Hollis spoke last night in the House of Lords, saying what the impact is on families, you should have seen the faces of those peers who hadn't really thought about it. And listening to Stuart just now when he's talking about making work pay, he really doesn't seem to understand what working family tax credits really do how they're used.
Let's go back to you, Stuart Jackson, because your own deputy chairman of your Conservative Association is in rebellion against what's been going on.
No, that's not true at all.
Yes, it is. We've just heard him on our programme.
Well, that's not the case.
You heard him.
Let's put this into context, John. We've had a reduction in adult unemployment of 50% in Peterborough, youth unemployment down two-thirds. We've got one of the fastest jobs growth rates in any urban area in Britain, the second highest private sector jobs growth. Yes, it's not perfect, but we've got to fill this £4.4 billion gap. Otherwise,
Stuart Jackson,
it will be more taxes on working people.
I don't hear you addressing the issue, which is that people were going to lose hundreds of pounds, people in your constituency, and you did nothing about it.
No,
and now you're
complaining
about the unelected Angela Smith messing about it within the House of Lords.
Well, there is an issue of whether the House of Lords has any democratic legitimacy or authority in its attempt to usurp the elected House when this policy actually, whether you agree with it or not, went through the House of Commons three times in the proper way. They have ridden the coach and horses round constitutional propriety, and in the end, when there is a Labour government again, it will happen to them. And it's absolutely
I think you've forgotten, Stuart, when you were a whip in the opposition when we were in government, your party voted against three statutory instruments and defeated them in the House of Lords. So we've done nothing different to what your party did when you were in opposition. I have
Angela,
to say, a lot of those people who are in work in your constituency now are in work, they can afford to be in work because they're getting working family tax credits. They probably couldn't afford to work without them. And taking away something like £1,300, £1,500 overnight in one foul swoop will make those families absolutely desperate and in some cases destitute. And they're working.
I will be working hard, as I've explained earlier.
Well, you didn't really.
I have lobbied. Well, it's a bit rich from you, Angela. When you were a PPS, you cut the 10p tax rate for the poorest working people as a political gimmick. So
well,
I'm
actually,
not going to take any lessons from you.
Learn from our mistakes, Stuart. Get it right the second time. If somebody points out something's wrong, try and make a change.
I am committed to looking after the interests of all my constituents, including the working people on low wages. I've championed the living wage. I think the national living wage is a fantastic policy. I believe that we were right to change the tax allowances and bring in extra childcare help. But we do need to do more, and I will be lobbying the Chancellor to offset some of the effects on some of the lower paid people in my constituency. Well,
you can be assured of that. But you voted without those changes.
Stewart Jackson, unfortunately, and Baroness Angela Smith, we're going to have to leave you there. Perhaps we'll be able to talk to you again next time about the fate of the House of Lords. Thank you both very much indeed.
Thank you. I've been getting old.